Man. Philly Music Man.
Hey. Yo, what's good, everybody? It's your boy, Philly Music Man, with my man, Barrelz the Beats.
Uh-huh. Finally Barrelz the Beats, Uptown Bully, baby.
Finally got to do this interview with him in a minute.
Man, it's been minutes.
But, yo, man, tell you about how you got started.
Man, back in the day, I started off this shit doing, like, battles back in the day. I was just battling more, like, Big Star era. Me, Cheek, Cicero, Vodka, before niggas was what they was. Like, you can go in the back tapes and you see niggas all in the background and all this shit like that. We was just mobbing, man. Just uptown niggas. I still fuck with all them niggas. Like, it's always love when I see them niggas because, you know, I was a street nigga for real, for real. You know, they just had the opportunity and they took it.
Now, how you came up with the name Barrelz the Beast?
Actually, I started off the name Grip Barrelz. Okay. I started off at Lil Grip. You know, my pop street name was Grip. So I was like, all right, fuck it. I'm going to go ahead and rock off with Lil Grip. And then motherfuckers used to be like, yo, you hard as shit, like gun barrel. Like, so I was like, all right, Grip Barrelz. I was Grip Barrelz for a while. And then, like, I got booked. I used to battle niggas on the gate. They used to be like, you a fucking beast. They be like, yo, man, Barrelz the Beast, man. Barrelz is a beast. And I put both of those together like, yo, that's what it is right there. Barrelz the Beast, man. You know, I was upstate. I'm talking about trashing niggas on that battle shit. I'm talking about Crown King of the Jail, all types of shit. That shit was love, man. It was love. You know, fucked up. I had to do it like that, but it is what it is, man.
Now, what makes you transfer from battling to recording ours?
Talent. Talent. I wanted more out of it. I mean, I started getting good at writing. Okay. You know, I started writing R&B songs for niggas that was singing up there in jail. I started writing songs. I was like, all right, fuck it. Let me sit down and write songs for myself. Mm. That shit started coming out nice.
Okay.
So, you know, that's what I was like, all right, I'm going to take on to the artistry thing. I'm not going to really lean on to the battle thing no more like that. But the battle thing is still in me because that's what I started at.
Okay.
Like if dudes hear me, like, acapella, my aggression, they'll know, like, oh, yeah, you can tell he was about that battle thing, man.
Okay, that's what's up. Now, I remember I seen Plenty of Time. Fire Chick had open mics.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So yeah. Like, one thing about me, man, I showed the city a lot of love.
Ain't no lie about mics. That.
Like, there's not a nigga in this city who could say, like, Barrelz ain't been here and performed, been there and performing. Like, a lot of these times, man, I did shit just on the strength because it's Philly.
Right.
And it's fucked up. You can't even get that same love back like yeah. that, for real, for real.
You're right about
real
that.
Real talk, man.
But I remember I saw you at the studio on 68th and Old Guns.
Yeah, Quiet Storm.
Everybody was there. You was there. Top Class was there. Rain Man. Listen. Yo, everybody went in.
That was love. Matter of fact, that was the cypher.
Right.
That was the cypher. Matter of fact, that was the cypher when I first came home from jail.
Okay.
When I first got, I had a house arrest bracelet on and anything. It was Rain Man. Matter of fact, Ines was in there that day too. There's a bunch of niggas in there. And you know, I was a little nervous. I'm like, damn, I don't know how they're gonna take to me coming home on some upstate aggressive shit.
Right.
So, they was like, just go. I went in. Rain Man was like, shit. I like killing this nigga fire right here. But at the whole time, his man Villain, that was my walkie. Shout okay. out my man Black Villain, you know, Bartram Village Projects. He came home too, he doing his thing. I told him like, yo man, your man Villain, he was like, you the boy he was talking about Barrelz. I'm like, yeah man, you know, I came home trying to do my thing, man, you know. He's like, man, just keep grinding, man. You know, I still salute Rain Man every day. I don't get to see him, but I talk to him on the book, probably on the phone or whatever like that. I salute him every day. He salute me every day because he one of the niggas that really paved them. He another nigga who paved the way for a lot of niggas in this city and don't get no credit for it.
Right.
I mean, nigga won battles on MTV.
Right.
How you can't salute a nigga like that? He's coming out of the city.
Right.
You can't. Like what a nigga gonna say? Oh, he dicky. That's not dicky. That's saluting, man.
Right. That's grown man.
That's the problem with you fucking young niggas. But like, you know, at the end of the day, it is what it is. Salute Rain Man. He already know it's love. Shout out Bartram Village, Enes, everybody out there, man.
You know, the difference is I saw you from last time, the glasses. What happened to the glasses?
Oh, man, I still got the glasses,
okay.
man. You know, I be doing a little contact lenses because, you know, glasses, you know, I be fucking and breaking them. I ain't going to keep spending $400-$500 on a pair of glasses and right. breaking them shit. So I'm like, all right, fuck it. I'm going to go ahead and do the contacts thing. And sometimes I even rock without them. But like, fuck it. You know, I even changed. I got the baldy now.
Yeah.
Like, I got hair on my head. I just cut the shit off. I like the baldy.
Now, when you do your music, well, what type of concepts you had and why you do it to them type of concepts that you about to say?
Basically, like, a lot of my concepts comes off of true life shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, motherfucker, when I first came home and I did that Live by the Trap song featuring Quilly Mills. Matter of fact, free Quilly Mills, man.
I know he's locked up.
Free Quilly Mills, man. That nigga was doing his motherfucking thing before he got booked. That Haines Street Hustle 5 did the pussy out here.
Yeah, that was hot.
Free Quilly Mills, man. For real, that was his best project. I got with him. He blessed the joint. Was like, listen, let's get it popping. Uptown shit, let's go. I did that Live by the Trap because I was somebody out here uptown running around in these streets, man. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, I did that off of life experiences. Everything comes from, like, life experiences. You know, I did the one clip, two clip with AR Ab.
Okay.
Free AR Ab, another nigga in the city who was doing his motherfucking thing, his motherfucking mud music, that shit on Pandora's box. Shout out to him. You can go buy that, all that. Free the nigga AR Ab. Shout out Dark Law and the whole OVH, man. Y'all niggas doing y'all thing out here. I did that one clip, two clip with him, man. You know, street niggas getting together talking about that work, man.
Right.
That what we was doing out here and what niggas is still doing out here. Ain't no fraud about it. It is what it is. You know, I can vouch for him, he can vouch for me. I met AR Ab through Mo, Free Mustafa, crashed on CEO. He be home soon. I met AR through him, and you know, backgrounds mixed with backgrounds, and we start knowing niggas that know each other, and that's how we got thorough.
Right.
But you know, I got a lot of love and a lot of respect from a lot of artists in this city. I ain't never had a problem with a nigga. I never will have a problem with a nigga. As simple as that. Niggas know my line of work. I go right upside a nigga head with no rap. But I ain't on that type time. You know, I got a son. My son won now.
Right.
I gotta be out here for him. I ain't going back to jail for no motherfucking body. I'm out here getting my money, raising my boy, making my music.
As you should.
You interrupt with that, now we got a problem.
Right. Now, what's on? You have a new project about to come out?
Right now, I'm working on my new project called Beast Mode.
Okay.
I was going to do Hyperthermia, but that was what, you know, my old current situation I was with OFU, we parted ways. Shout out Brian Anderson, never no love lost. I look at him today still as a big brother mentor. You know, we just seen different ways, you know, their vision was different. I wasn't fitting their vision, so, you know, we parted ways.
Okay.
All business, always love. When we see each other, we talk to each other, whatever like that. He even just called me on the phone, checked me about my Wave Juice cover. Like, why the fuck would you put that nut-ass cover for that Wave Juice song? Like, right. You know how that shit's supposed to be done. You know, that's why I had to come back. All right, you're right, you got me. But, you know, I learned a lot from B-Ball, man. You know, I learned, you know, always look cool. Be yourself.
Right. Image mean everything,
man. You know, your image is everything. A lot of niggas don't know that, man. Your image is everything when you come in this music thing, because at the end of the day, people really look at you like, fuck, he got on. What he doing? What's going on in his neighborhood? This, that, and the third.
Like, right.
Image is everything. And if a lot of y'all niggas got fucked up images and don't want to clean yourself up when it's time to clean yourself up, because y'all never know who be around, man. That's why they call me Mr. Wavy. Hey, they always see me with something crazy on, man.
As you should.
But like, so, you know, right, currently I'm working on Beast Mode. Right now, you know, I'm just dropping, you know, little samples of what you're going to hear on the mixtape.
Okay.
I'm going to do a lot of features.
Okay, who's some of the features?
Right now, everybody know I got McVay with Wave Juice, John.
Okay.
McVay from Big Paper, shout out Big Papers, Uptown niggas. Black De Niro gonna be on there.
Okay.
I'm still getting a couple features together. I mean, I don't really want to dog them too much with the features, because, you know, I still want to give them me, because, you know, I'm a free agent. I'm by myself and I'm pushing myself.
Right.
I'm pushing Barrelz of Beast as a brand. So I don't want to be trying to, niggas be like, oh, he's trying to ride off somebody's coattail. No, I got my own buzz. I came home from jail and I did this. I opened up for Jadakiss. I opened up for Cash Money. I opened up for a lot of motherfuckers in this city. Won competition from Chicago, Jersey, New York. anywhere. Baltimore, D.C. I'd have been anywhere with this music shit. I did a lot more than a lot of you motherfuckers did that been out here for years.
And your downloads show it, too.
Yeah, listen, man. Go on netpiff.com right now. My first mixtape, Certified Bronx. 28,000 downloads. Mm. Certified Bronx, man. You know, I was out here working. I was doing me. You know, I took the pedal. I took my foot off the pedal. Had my son. Fell back for a year, and I'm getting back at it, man. I'm getting back at it, but I was still, you know, putting out things here and there, here and there. You know, shout out to Philly Music, man. You know, he always showed me love. Always love. Like, bro, you hot, man.
Yeah, it's worth it. You show it. Every time I saw you, was doing something.
I mean, you hot. Like, everybody knew me. I was working.
Now, how do you come up with your stage performance? Because you have a lot of energy on your stage performance. Is it something you just freestyle, or something you already just...
I use my stage performance during like my energy when I used to come from battling, cause I'm a snap rapper.
Okay.
I'm a snap rapper, but like when I first came home, I used to be on the stage or just battling, just like just one motion. I'm just here. You know, one thing about b-ball show you how to work that stage.
Okay.
B-ball was like, nah, Beast, you got to move around on that stage more. He's like, you move around, but you don't move around enough. You got to loosen up.
Okay.
So, you know, I started loosening up, and then like my stage presence started getting better at its own. It's not about going up there trying to dance or anything like that. It's about going up there showing your swag and your charisma.
Mm-hmm.
Because a lot of y'all niggas be on stage holding y'all dick, looking at your man rapping. Nigga, look at the crowd.
Right.
I see that shit all the time. I be like, what the fuck is you? Who, you performing for me, not your fucking man.
Right, right.
Get your hand off your dick, nigga.
Right.
I don't want to see that. But that's just real shit, though.
Right.
And then, you know, like, you know, stage performance is everything to me. And that's very important when you performing at these showcases, because you never know who in the building.
Yeah, because a person can sign you for your talent, but they're looking to see how much money they can make off you.
Right.
You can entertain.
Right.
You got a lot of entertainers. Yeah.
Then they gonna be like, listen, man, I'm not trying to go through all this. We gotta get a choreographer. We gotta show this motherfucker how to do this. Show mm-hmm. a motherfucker how to do that. That's why you use these open mics and all that for practice.
Right. Right.
Like a lot of motherfuckers don't know these open mics help you, man. Like, too bad they don't really do too many open mics like that in the city no more. Mm-hmm. I remember open mics used to be popping every week.
Right.
Every week used to be open mics.
Shout out to Larry Lair. He was one of them, too.
Shout out Larry Lair.
Yeah.
That's who I opened up with Cash Money. I won Larry Lair joint down that ring.
Okay.
I bombed that joint. He was like, you won hands down.
But you know, not to cut you off, it's one thing I like about you. When I first met about, first taught you, you had the street attitude, but you humble.
Yeah.
That's one thing about you. And plus, you can take constructive criticism.
All day.
You know, where, oh, do this, do that. Because I hear with your interview how you say how you learn from other people telling you about your mistakes and how to better yourself.
Exactly. One thing about me, man, like women to tell you, too. I'm a listener.
Okay.
You know what I mean? I learned being a listener from older heads. I don't hang with motherfuckers my age. I hang with motherfuckers. I go to old head bars and I sit down and I talk to old heads.
Okay.
I'm a listener. And that helped me actually within myself to have patience. Constructive criticism, tell me if I'm doing something wrong, tell me.
Right.
You know what I mean? If it's fucked, if I think it's fucked up, let me learn the hard way. But I'm going to take it in, definitely.
Right.
I'm definitely going to take it in. One thing, and then, you know, humble yourself. One thing about me, like, I did a lot of shit out here, but one thing, I never been arrogant with nobody. I never told a nigga I charge you to get on the track. For what? Ain't nobody making no fucking money out here doing that shit. Fuck, I'm gonna give you $200, $300 for it to get on my shit. I told a nigga, like, I did tracks with the best of them. Niggas who got the top buzzers and say, I ain't put a fucking coin out my pocket.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So I tell niggas, stop, like, don't charge niggas in your city. Charge niggas outside your city if you don't charge niggas. Because at the end of the day, that's why we all can't eat in the city. Ain't nobody cutting no check. So why the fuck would I want to, why would I want to pay him to get on my shit when he probably not going to sound better than me on mine? Because it's hard to bomb me on my own shit anyway. It's hard to be on the track and get even with me anyway, because everybody know I'm a barbarian.
Okay, I heard that.
Shout out F-Chain. F-Chain. Matter of fact, F-Chain, man. F-Chain putting on right now. He moving out here, man. Shout out to F-Chain, man. He moving. That's what he called me. He said, Barrelz, man. Barrelz all bars, man. You know what you're going to get with him, man. He a barbarian.
No, no.
I said, I like that.
What type of rappers do you feel that meet your style that you like to do a track with?
Right now, I don't listen to none of this shit that's out.
Okay.
What I listen to right now, I got Four Horsemen in my car.
Yeah, that's hot.
Shout out to Hollow Man, Reed Dollars, Chink the Great. I was just in the studio with him and Cree Forge. Yeah. That was a nice project y'all put together, man.
Definitely.
That was Philly rap. I ain't heard that type of Philly rap since State Property era and all that shit. And I'm just keeping it a beam because a lot of this shit out here now, everybody trying to mimic the next person.
Okay.
Like what happened to staying in your lane? That's what made Philly different from everybody.
Right.
We had our own lane. Now y'all trying to, it's okay to cross over, but don't lose yourself when you cross over.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? One thing about me, niggas know like I make trap music, but I'm still Barrelz the Beast. When you hear me on that trap music, I'm still Barrelz the Beast on that trap music.
Right.
Niggas get on these other tracks and they start sounding like MC Ketchup and Mustard. I be like, who is this?
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? And right. There's a lot of niggas out here, and that's just how it is. I mean, it's really right now in Philly, it ain't really no more true spitters like that, man.
Uh-huh.
There's a couple of us still out here. Del P.
Yeah, he's nice.
Del P Fire. That's my man. He good dude. Fire. It's a lot of niggas. High Def. I like Ice is a saver.
Yeah, Ice, she's nice.
That's my heart right there.
Yeah,
she's
Ice, a fucking good people. Animal.
She better than a lot of niggas out here.
Yeah, she's nice.
It's a lot. It's so many. I forget my man Conflict. Shout out McVeigh. It's a lot of niggas, and I don't want to forget niggas because that's the truth.
Right.
Black De Niro, they already know because they already got their buzzes and all that already. So I ain't got to really keep shouting the same niggas out. My man Biggs turned up. He next up coming out of Uptown. He working.
He working cash and
I mean cash.
Yeah, cash.
We was just all in the booth together. I mean, shout out to all them niggas. They whole movement. It's a lot of niggas out here moving, man.
Now I got a question for you. Where you see yourself at in 2 years' time off of rap music?
2 years' time, well, like I can't really predict that. Only a lot of Isla can predict that. But at the end of the day, in 2 years' time, listen, man, I ain't got no record deal. I'm going to get me a young boy and I'm going to write for him.
Okay.
I'm going to get me a young boy and I'm going to write for him. I'm going to push him. I'm going to take him through everything that I went through. Everything that I went to, at the end of the day, Barrelz ain't selfish.
Okay.
I want to see a motherfucker eat. I want to see somebody make it. Like, I see Meek made it.
Right.
He came from nigga, he ain't got no fucking money in his pocket. Y'all can hate on him all you want. Oh, Meek arrogant, this and that. He won. The nigga's a millionaire.
Yeah.
What more you want?
Right.
He a millionaire. Like, fuck it. Let him talk his shit. He ride around in Rolls Royces and all that. He ain't got to never work from the day of his life. Only thing he got to work is keep making his music. That's how he make his money.
Right.
Like, if he didn't get signed, he'd probably still be running around with the same dickheads trying to get signed. That
right.
Don't got no deal.
Right.
He had to separate himself and get a deal. Simple as that. You can't hate the nigga for that. It's just real.
Right.
You know, that's basically like 2 years from now. Like, if things ain't really doing, moving, shaking and baking for Barrelz the Beast, man, you know, I'm going to go ahead. I'll step back to the side, get a little youngin', raise him, send him to the wolves, man, and he going to be an animal, too.
That's smart.
He's
going
to be an animal.
That songwriting money is good money.
Yeah, that's good money, man. And you know, I know about the market. I know how to look, how you're supposed to look. You know what I'm saying? It ain't about changing a whole nigga outfit or whatever like that. It's really about cleaning yourself up nice, man. You know, making yourself look presentable. Because at the end of the day, the female's paying attention.
Yeah, ain't a lot
female's
about that.
Paying attention, man. Because at the end of the day, the female's gonna be like, he like a dirty nigga. What the fuck is he talking all this money shit for? He ain't even got no new sneaks on.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? If it don't add up, make it add up. Or make it look like it add up.
Right.
For real. The state of hip-hop in Philly, man, it's just everything changed, man. I mean, the battle scene not the same no more.
No, not at all.
Like, I like I'm a fan of battling, but I don't like though this new way that niggas battle. Like, it's like everything is a joke.
Yeah, it's like being comedians.
You know what you look like? You look like I don't want to hear that. I want to hear a nigga go bar for bar. Let's see what your book about. Let's see what your pen game about.
Right.
That's battling.
Right.
I mean, unless y'all going off the top of the head. Freestyling off the top of the hill, you writing some shit down on the paper and memorizing it and going.
Well, it seems like the old school battle rap trying to come back out. I know Rain battle in January, Reed trying to come back.
Yeah,
Shotgun Sugar. It's like,
matter of fact, Reed working on a new project too. I seen this shit on the gram. He working on something new. A lot of niggas coming back. Christendom, they working on that Rockefeller shit again.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? You know, shout out to them. You know, free Beanie Siegel. Yeah. You know, I did a show with him out in VA with Tone Trump and all them niggas. Like,
okay.
I've been around the best of them, man.
I know.
Honestly, say I was blessed with that. You know, running with the Quiet Storm movement, I've been around the best of them. I molded myself with the OFU situation.
Now I'm about to drop my last CD, Real Hip Hop Volume 5, Finished Business. I definitely got to get you on.
Oh, yeah, you already know.
I need you on that.
You already know, man. You know, listen, man. Anybody in the city know, man, when it comes to Barrelz, like, just let me know. And I did 12 features in 2 weeks.
Dang, okay.
12 features in 2 weeks. I'm going to be on 12 different mixtapes.
That's smart.
I don't have a problem with it because I love this shit.
Yep.
I mean, at the end of the day, I'm not an arrogant nigga. I'm a humble dude. You can come talk to me. I can come talk to you. I can address the situation if I don't like it.
Right.
Come address the situation to me if you don't like it. Simple as that. That's just how I am. I was cut from a different cloth. I mean, like, I'm an 80s baby. I'm cut from that cloth.
Okay.
Not the new babies.
I heard that. My brother, it's a pleasure.
You already
know,
it's a long time
waiting. I'm glad we finally got to meet
on this interview. This was much needed, man.